Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to build an AI agent using the IBM watsonx Orchestrate ADK. The ADK enables developers to create, manage, and enhance agents in Watson Orchestrate. For this video, we're going to use the ADK documentation to walk you through a couple of examples to build a simple agent and then add a tool to it. Let's begin. So we're going to go to the tutorial section and open creating your first agent on Agent Builder. This page has instructions to create a very simple Hello World agent. To create your agent, you need a couple of files, a YAML file and additional Python files if you want to include tools. In the YAML file, there's going to be important definitions or descriptions of your agent. First, we have the name of the agent. Then we have the description. The next field is instructions. You can think of instructions as the system prompt of the agent. This is going to tell the agent how it should behave and also how it should use the tools or agents that it has at its disposal. Then we have the LLM, which can be any of the LLMs available in watsonx.ai. Then we have the style. The style defines how the agent is going to reason in order to provide answers. If we feel confident the LLM can use its native capabilities, we can go with the default. But if we want a more sophisticated model for reasoning, we can use other approaches. For this example, we stay with default. Then we have the collaborators. In this context, collaborators are other agents that can be invoked by these particular agents depending on the context of the conversation. And then we have tools. For those coming from watsonx Orchestrate Gen 1, tools are similar to skills. So these are specific integrations or programs that you can invoke from your agent to accomplish or complete a particular task. In this case, we're going to use only one tool, which is greeting. Now, the next file is going to define what the greeting tool is and does. So let's go to the next section. So this is the Python file. In this file, we're going to describe what is the behavior, the input, and the output of this particular tool. All this tool does is every time that is invoked, it's going to return the string hello world. It doesn't have any input parameters. Okay, now the last part of this section that I want to talk about is the commands. This section describes what are the commands you need to do, you need to run in order to import these files into Watson Orchestrate. Okay, so we're going to copy these files into Visual Studio Code. And as you can see here, I've created already these two files. One is the greeter.yaml file with the code provided in the tutorial. Here is the other file, greetings.py, with the tool that we're going to be calling. Now let's go to the terminal and we're going to run these commands. First, I'm going to run the command using the exact syntax that appears in the tutorial. And this is going to fail. But I wanted to run this just in case people are doing the steps just like I did, and you can understand what is the problem. So I'm going to run this command. And it's failing because it's telling us that there was no module named greetings. If you follow the steps of the tutorial, I think there is an omission to the location of these files, because this is expecting file to be under tools. However, there's no reference to create in the tools folder. So you can either create a tools folder or you can modify the string to say that this file is located under the root folder of your project. So in my case, I'm just going to modify it, and I'm just going to remove the tools reference. Now, this command is going to fail again for a different reason, but I wanted to show you this because this is a common problem that you might run into. So if you haven't activated your environment, or you haven't used it in a while, you might have to reactivate your session in order to connect to your Watson Orchestrate tenant. So that's the problem we're having here. I just need to activate my environment. So I'm going to run the command orchestrate env activate and the name of my environment. When you run this command, it's going to ask you for your API key. You can obtain your API key from the Watson Orchestrate tenant. And in this case, we successfully activated the environment. So we're going to run one more time. Hopefully this time will work. So let's import our tool. You have to import the tools first before you import the agent. So again, Orchestrate tools import, and it completed the process. So once the tool has been registered in Watson Orchestrate, now we can proceed to create the agent using the definition in the YAML file. Run demand, and it finished successfully. So now we're going to move into Watson Orchestrate. As you can see here, there is the greeter agent we just created. So we're going to open it, and now we're going to move and inspect certain sections of the agent. Here's the description that we have in our YAML file. Scrolling down, we find the style. Again, there's two options to using to define the style of the agent. We're going to go with the default. There is another section for knowledge. Here you can import files or connect it to Milvus repository if you want that capability to be part of your agent. For this example, we're going to skip this. And now we're going to go to tools. Here we see listed the tool that we imported, the greeting tool. So everything is looking fine. The last part, the agent definition, is the behavior. This is like the system prompt. It's very simple. It's telling us that when people say greeting, it should return, it should invoke the greetings tool. Okay, so now let's move to the right panel, which is the space where we can have conversations with our agent. We're gonna type greeting, and this is gonna invoke our agent. So the agent is gonna identify and follow the instructions from our prompt, and has identified the tool, it's calling it, and it's coming back with an answer, hello world. Now, if we wanna get more details about how the agent came up with this as the right answer, we can show the reasoning. So we're gonna expand this section, and it's showing us that there is one step. Let's go inside the step. And it's showing us that for this particular interaction, there was no input required. As we described before, this tool doesn't take any input parameters and is providing one output, which is hello world. Okay. Now we'll get back to our documentation because we're going to introduce a new tool. Okay. So for that, we're going to take an example providing in a different part of the documentation. So let's move away from tutorials, and we're going to go into tools. And we're going to use this example as a starting point of our new tool. This is the example. And this is the Python example of creating a new tool. This tool is not introducing any functionality if we copy it as is. All this example is doing is describe what are the libraries you need to call and what is the syntax that you need to introduce for this code to be recognized as a valid tool. So we could start with this and create our own code, but we're going to do something a little bit different. If you look in the right corner, there is a button here that says Ask AI. And this is a very cool functionality of the website. When you click on this, it is going to open a window where you can chat with an AI. By default, when you open this, it's going to explain the code snippet, right? So this AI is going to look at the code and it's going to generate an explanation. And it's describing what the tool is, what it's doing, and what are the requirements for the tool. As this is something useful if you just want to understand better what the code is doing. But you can do more than just explaining the code. We're going to ask the AI to write code for us. So I'm going to say, can you modify this code so the functionality of the tool implements the logic to convert a word into pig Latin. It has produced the code and is describing what are the key changes that introduce in reference to the starting point. And it's telling us it changed the tool name, it updated the description, and is also describing is what are the rules of pig Latin. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to the top and just copy the code of this snippet so we can introduce a new tool. So I'm back in Visual Studio. I have created a new file called piglatin.pi, and we're going to paste the code. And I'm just going to change two things here to keep things consistent. I'm going to change the name of the tool, and I'm going to change also the name of the function. Once we have changed those, we need to tell the agent that there is a new tool that the agent can use. To do that, we have to modify two things. First, we have to include this in the list of tools available. So we go back to the YAML
and add one new line for our tool.
Then we modify the instructions to let the agent know there is a new tool and how to use it. So I'm just saying, when asked to convert a word to pig Latin, use the tool pig_Latin. So now we save these files and we're gonna run our import commands. So I'm gonna run import. First, remember you have to import the tools so the agent knows about the existence of this. I'm importing pig Latin. Okay, that completed. Now we're gonna run another command to update our agent. So we're gonna import the agent. And now we can go back to Watson Orchestrate. So I'm going to refresh my session here. And now we have a new version of the greeter agent. So let's inspect the changes to see if they look okay. So we're going first to the tool section. And as you can see, there is a new tool available here, which is pig Latin. Let's go and see the behavior. We had changed the behavior using a different prompt. And here we see the updated reference to use the tool to convert words into pig Latin. So let's go to the chat. So I'm gonna say, convert the word dog into pig Latin. And it says the word dog in pig Latin is ugly. Okay, now we're gonna expand one of these sections just to see what additional information we can see that describe how the agent came up with this answer. So in here, we see that there was, for this particular answer, only one step, which makes sense. And like the previous time we expanded this, this time we see that there is an input, and the word for the input was dog. What is interesting here is that we never say that the input for calling this tool was going to be the word dog. Right? We just say convert the word dog into pig Latin. So the LLM was able to understand the meaning of our sentence and identify that the input in this case was going to be dog. This was also not explicitly defined in the behavior we introduced. We just say, when someone asks you to convert the word, use this tool. We never said what are going to be the input parameters. So this is showing the thinking capabilities of the LLM, not only to understand the intention of our comments, but also the ability to understand and extract what is going to become the input of our tools. In this case, this works pretty well because the example is pretty simple. In some more elaborated cases, you will have to provide more specific instructions in order to be able to parse more complex type of inputs. Now let's recap. In this video, I'll show you how to use the ADK to create your first agent programmatically. We create our first hello world just running a couple of commands and examples from the documentation. And then we created a new tool into our agent that expanded the capabilities of the agent. And we use AI to write the code. Then we run the same commands just to update our agent, and the tool was quickly and easily incorporate into behavior of the agent. Using this pattern, you can expand the functionality of your agents using programming languages and APIs to connect your agents with other applications. Thanks for watching this video.